start with some of the campus team. Those are the athletes we chose to follow over the weeks leading up to the games, like the Canadian snowboarder Audrey McManaman and the men's curling team from Sweden. She's only 18. She won the gold in slopestyle at the Youth Olympic Games at Innsbruck in 2012. A student at Quebec City. And here at the Universiade, she competed in two disciplines, slopestyle and the halfpipe. I just arrived. I've been waiting for this moment, you know. I'm so excited. I trained for it for a long, long time. We've seen the halfpipe track. It's really nice. Good construction as well. And, you know, I'm ready to go. And so into the halfpipe with her friends Anfred and Tamara, also in the Canadian snowboard team, giving her plenty of support. But in the semi-finals, on the second run, she would fall. Audrey, a bit disappointed. She'd hoped to make that final round. I missed my landing, but I guess in the end, the halfpipe is only my second discipline. I just try the halfpipe for pleasure, really. I'm sure in slopestyle, things will be better. And a few days later, the last day of the Universiade, this was Audrey's second run in the final in slopestyle. If she lands correctly on this second run, she could be the winner. But unfortunately, Audrey made an early mistake, and now she'd have to take risks to have any chance of a place on the podium. If she's doing tricks like this, it means she fell down on the first jump. I don't think she's happy. No podium for Audrey. She finishes fourth. Unfortunately, I fell in both final rounds. Do you know, I should have been able to do that run easily. I made unforgivable mistakes, I really did. But the season is just beginning, and I will go on. For sure, I'm disappointed. I missed the podium. But you know, that's sport, isn't it? And you simply need to carry on. Baselga de Pinay, the headquarters for the Swedish curling team. Oscar Eriksson and his mates.
It's a big honor representing Sweden, for sure. This is the first time with this team, so it's new for all of us together. Let's go to the hotel and meet the rest of the team. Let's go.
Where we found the guys really relaxed, playing cards. Didn't they have exams to work for?
We don't want to study when we are in a tournament. He has to study more, so maybe he needs to study, but I don't have to study.
I have to study quite a lot now when I'm here, but I'm focused on the curling when I have to and the studies. Yeah, later on the nights and stuff like that. So.
We were in Canada for 5 weeks and played five tournaments against the best teams in the world. And we did pretty good in three tournaments and tried our best in the other two.
And the boys are not alone. Two mums have come over from Sweden to support their boys. Stage. Sweden, right up there at the top. They lost just one match, that against the Canadians. But then the semi-finals against Norway. They didn't start too well. But finally, Norway buckled and Sweden won 6-3 in 10 ends of play.
They played a much better game than they did in the group. So it was really tight. They managed to steal one in the fifth end to go up to 2-1. After that, we said we just have to keep playing really good and hope to get a big break. And we did it already in the sixth end. So since that, we just controlled the game. Today is the big day, the final. I feel relaxed and really comfortable. This is what we've been waiting for all week, to play the final.
So once more onto the ice, the final against Great Britain. The Swedish boys really focused. We had a few fans there as well, willing them to victory. And they won the gold medal for Sweden and the campus team.
Playoffs were tough. We played good. All Norway and Great Britain played good as well, but we were the better team.
In 4 years, Olympics. We will see you there.
See you in South Korea.